Oh, good morning. I'm Torrey Snow in for C4 here with Bryan Nehman, and it's Ravens season time. I went to the game against New Orleans last week. I was doing the Ravens game day thing. It was a lot of fun. I got to see the preseason game. It is preseason time, and so we try to give everybody an update on what's going on with the Ravens. Joining us is Femi Ayanbadejo. He's a member of the Ravens broadcast team and, of course, was the illustrious champion, one of the champions from our Super Bowl 35. Femi, thanks for joining us, man. How are things looking for tomorrow?
Yeah, you know, it's going to be interesting. Some of the feedback and stuff I've been, you know, trying to triangulate through social media and just radio and things like that. It looks like it was a bit of a rough day yesterday. But, you know, we're in the dog days of training camp. So we haven't been able to avoid the injury bug, obviously. So my hope is that the guys that need to perform go out there and perform tomorrow, and that hopefully there's not another, you know, flurry of injuries to add to the ever-growing injury list.
Before we talk about Carolina and, you know, what to expect this week, what did you think about the performance against New Orleans? I realize it's, you know, vanilla offense and things like that, but it was a struggle moving the football last week.
Yeah, the offensive line to me was the weak spot. You know, I didn't like the third down conversions the secondary allowed to the first team New Orleans offense on those first couple drives. Obviously, a ton of guys that would normally be out there during the season on a Sunday were not out there. But I did love the explosiveness of the defense. I did love the turnovers. I love some of the flashes that I saw from Huntley. Man, the mannerisms, and I said this last year, but it still shocks me the way he carries himself. Man, he's so much like Lamar, and it's just who he is. I mean, you can't fake, you know, Huntley's mannerisms or the way he plays the game. Obviously, watching Lamar every day probably has a little impact on him, but you've got to have some of those skills in your toolkit to go out there and look the way that Huntley did. So overall, I don't take too much from a preseason game, but since it's the only thing that we can really measure that's right, like live bullet, it was okay. They won the game. That's kind of the goal at the end. There wasn't a ton of injuries that came out of it. I think I saw Tavon out there, right, Austin? I think he was out there last weekend, wasn't he? So I think that did he not play?
I don't remember seeing him.
The point is that he's healthy and he's going to be available, hopefully, for this season. He's such a great nickel corner. I really want to see him out there. And the fact that he's not hurt and is available, I'm excited about. Let's hope that continues. But generally speaking, it's kind of what I expect from a preseason game based on who was out there.
Yeah, so when we're at this phase of football, what is it that people are trying to pull out? Like, what should someone like me be looking for? Are we looking for the play call? Because that's what I was thinking. Like, you know, how good are we playing calling plays? What are we thinking as far as, you know, how we're executing cohesion with the team? What kind of things should we be looking for?
Well, I think what you want to look for really is that it's the first time that they're going to have refs kind of on the field. They might have refs in practice, but it's not the same. You know, are they getting the play in and executing before the play clock? Are there a bunch of offside penalties? Are there a bunch of just, you know, penalties in general in regard to holding and, you know, holding on the offensive line, you know, PIs, things like that? I didn't see a ton of that. And they're running a vanilla offense for the most part, and Wink's vanilla defense can be rather complex compared to some other teams out there. So I just think it's kind of the operational piece, right? You want to see if the play coming in, the execution and operation is going the way that you want, you know. And obviously you want to see young guys compete and see that when you let go of their hand, figuratively speaking, are they able to go out there if they're a lower round pick, even if they're a higher round pick, are they able to go out there and play with other NFL caliber players? That's really what you're looking for. Who are the diamonds in the rough? Who are the guys that maybe didn't practice that well but showed up on Saturday or Thursday or whatever your preseason game is? And who are the guys that look great in practice but didn't really perform well in the game? You know, what can you surmise from what you're able to see? I think that's kind of like the 30,000-foot view that you should take. And where are the positional battles at? We have a battle at running back right now, I believe. I think Justice Hill right now. I really like what I saw from is it Williams, I believe, is his last name, number 34. I really like what I saw from him. Can he continue to build on what he did against New Orleans? So I think that's the view that I take. I try not to get too riled up or too emotionally invested. It's hard for me, as you guys can tell. I'm a pretty emotional, passionate person. But as my with my analyst hat on and my executive hat on, that's kind of how I look at it.
Yeah. We're talking with Femi Ayanbadejo, member of the Ravens broadcast team. Ravens taking on the Panthers tomorrow night down in Carolina. They've been practicing down there for the last couple of days as well. And the scrimmage aspect of it, there have been more injuries. There was a freaking ambulance called out the other day for Mark Andrews. Looks like he's going to be okay, but it's the last thing that you want to hear. We did get a quarterback hurt, Trace McSorley. And I know that's been a big battle between Trace and Tyler. Where do you think that aspect is right now? Because I thought Huntley looked a lot better than McSorley did last weekend. Your thoughts on the backup situation to Lamar Jackson?
Yeah, I mean, I think they need to keep both of them, to be honest. You know, hopefully Trace's back is not, it's not a serious thing that's going to linger forever. You know how back injuries can be, I know personally. But what I've heard anecdotally from people that have been at practice daily is that Trace has actually looked a little bit better than Tyler. But then when we watch the preseason game, Tyler looks like, to me, he can run the Lamar Jackson offense. Like, that's what I saw. Tyler's a lot more explosive. He brings a little bit of a, extension, get a first down with his feet. And I know Trace can do a little bit of that, but he's just not quite the same as Tyler. You know what I mean? In my opinion, from what I saw, I would give Tyler, because I go based on the live bullets aspect. I do know that you usually got to do it in practice first for it to carry over to a game. And I haven't been out to practice yet. I've been able to watch some stuff on YouTube. I've been able to talk to some people. But generally speaking, I would give Tyler Huntley the advantage. And Tyler's healthy. You know, the best ability is availability, that cliche that's been thrown around every day by everybody on every network all the time now during training camp, right? But I do think that him being healthy gives him the edge at this point. And based on what I saw on Saturday night, that gives him the advantage in my opinion at this time. But I think they need to keep both, because with COVID, Lamar's not vaccinated. Who knows what can happen? Like, that's got to be part of the calculation going through this season. COVID is going to be an input in every decision they make. For every player that's not vaccinated. And I hate to bring that up, but that's just a fact.
Yeah. Well, definitely worth noting. Thank you so much for joining us, Femi, and appreciate your analysis and all your insights on our games. Have a fantastic day. Be safe, man.
You as well, guys. Have a great weekend.
Yeah.